This is Lavender Recap. In today's video, we'll be going through an American science fiction and action movie from the year 2005 titled As War of the Worlds. Spoilers ahead! The movie opens with Ray's working scene. Ray's a happy-go-lucky type of man working in New York as a loading dock crane operator. He's living a life free from any responsibility. But on the other hand, he is the divorced father to a young girl and a teenager. His ex-wife Catherine and her new husband are waiting for him as Ray reaches home from work. His teenage son Robbie and his daughter Rachel will stay with him for the weekend, but Ray has forgotten this due to the workload. Rachel welcomes Ray by hugging him while Robbie is rude and calls him Ray instead of Dad. Catherine and her husband finds out that Ray's not really prepared as there is no food in the fridge and the place is a mess. Catherine informs him about the kids' schooling, and the kids stay in their old room in their house. Catherine says that she's going to Boston to her parents, and as he walks Catherine out, he assures her that there is no need to worry as he will take full care of the kids over the weekend. Ray listens to news about strange lighting happening in different parts of the world. He then decides to play catch with Robbie to make up for earlier in the day, but Robbie tells his dad that he hates him, and things get heated. During the play, Ray hits the ball through a window and then Robbie goes back into the house. Ray takes a nap and tells Rachel to order anything she wants to eat. A couple of hours later, Ray wakes up to eat with Rachel and asks for Robbie, but he finds out that Robbie has driven out with Ray's car. Ray goes outside and sees his car is gone. People are stopping and are staring at the sky as they have never seen this kind of vortex in the sky before. The wind starts blowing as they head to the backyard to have a better look. Rachel joins Ray outside to have a look. All of a sudden, the wind lights down and lighting begins frequently. Rachel asks Ray to go inside the house. They hide under the table until the lightning stops, and Ray comforts Rachel, and the lightning usually doesn't strike twice at the same place, but then it does. Ray finds out that all electricity stopped and that his cell phone isn't working. Neither is his watch. The neighbors also say the electricity is gone or dead, and dozens of cars are standing in the middle of the road when Ray steps outside. He finds Robbie and tells him to go to the house. Robbie tells him that he counted 26 lightning strikes at the same spot. His mechanic friend also confirms the story. People now gather at the center of the town where lightning struck, and Ray joins them. There is a huge roll surrounded by concrete and asphalt. There is a roaring sound coming out of the ground, but police confirm that there are no pipes or anything other underground making that noise. Everyone goes back as the cracks and rumbling increases. The windows of the houses start breaking, and the buildings start shaking. A circular disc is formed in the middle of the street, and the shaking stops. There is a loud roar as the disc rotates. A gigantic mechanical thing comes out from the rumble and smoke, and Ray can barely escape as the tentacle drops. The crowd gathers at the edge of the disc, and shaking stops. A huge machine comes out of the hole, and it stands on its three legs and is several hundred feet tall. People start running in fear. The tripod gives a siren and then starts striking a heatwave towards people. The heatwave is so intense that it vaporizes people in less than a second, and it starts eliminating people. People start to run for their lives. Ray somehow manages to escape from it and watches it move towards the city. He goes to his house in complete shock, washes his mouth, and remains silent when Rachel asks what happens. He then collects his gun from the bedroom and asks Robbie to collect as much food as possible. With his kids, Ray reaches Manny the mechanic to find a working car and makes them enter the first car they see. Manny tries to stop Ray, but Ray on the other hand tries to convince him that he should join them in the car, but he's not willing to cooperate. Ray drives off, and the tripod vanishes Manny as soon as they drive away. They speed up the car as the tripod is destroying everything behind them. When they go on the highway passing through jammed cars, and he tells Robbie that they are attacked but fails to tell what the thing is. He says maybe lightning activates the tripod. Ray heads to Catherine's house as she's in Boston, in her parents' house. The house is empty, and he finds out that the basement is a safe place to get some rest. They wake up because of the ground shaking, lightning and fire, but somehow manage to keep themselves safe. In the morning, Ray finds out the house is destroyed, and a massive burning plane engine is present in the living room. He finds out that there was a plane crash and sees someone dragging out the airplane food trolley. The media crew tries to gather all the food. The reporter tells him they're reporting the military fight with the tripods, but unfortunately the tripods have some shield and due to that, missiles, bombs, etc. have no impact on the tripods. She shows footage of dozens of tripods attacking different cities, and more lightning strikes result in more tripods, and then the crew leaves. Ray decides to use small roads instead of highways in big cities, and Robbie suggests fighting with the tripods. Rachel needs to pee and they head to the riverbank to stop. Many dead bodies are floating on the water and Rachel gets scared. Ray shuts her eyes with his hand, but she has seen so much already. Robbie begs the army jeeps to take him with them to fight with invaders, but Ray stops him, which makes Robbie angry again. Robbie says that Ray wants to run for his responsibility, and that's the reason why he wants to head to Boston. They continue driving further in silence. They reach a town and people start to bang on the car. Some are asking for help and others are becoming furious. When Ray hits a pole, people drag him and Robbie out of the car while Rachel is stuck inside. Ray puts out his gun, but someone else points at him. He drops his gun and picks up Rachel and Robbie and moves out of sight. Someone picks up Ray's gun, and as they set out in a diner, the person shoots the driver of Ray's car. This is scaring Rachel, and the crowd goes away with the car. The family continues their journey by foot and boat to cross the Hudson River to Boston. In line, Ray meets his friend Cheryl. Rachel notices many birds flying away from the town, and when Ray looks behind him, he sees a tripod heading to town. People start running, and the whole situation gets extremely chaotic. The captain of the ferry decided he had to leave. The ferry detaches from the dock and more tripods appear on the scene. Ray somehow escapes the guards and boards the ferry. He gets furious as there is still plenty of room for other people to save. The captain believes the boat is safe, but a tripod comes out of the river, tilts the ferry, and it capsizes. Everyone on the boat ends up in the river. Ray somehow manages to hold on to the kids and reaches the riverbank. The family goes into the woods as more tripods start vaporizing the people. They go into the countryside where more refugees are present. Once there is an explosion, Ray goes to have a look. It is the fight between the army and tripods, and Robbie runs towards it. Ray follows him, and soldiers stop Robbie from going there, but the missiles and explosions have somewhat faded. Robbie and Ray see strangers taking Rachel with them, and due to this, he has to leave Robbie. Ray takes Rachel, and a person with a shotgun invites him to an underground shelter. His name is Harlan, and mentions that tripods are buried under the earth for thousands of years. They're here for the extermination of humans. He asks Ray to join him in the fight as he lost his whole family in it. The basement starts shaking and part of the house collapses. They see the tripods come in and Harlan is dedicated to fight them, but Ray feels desperate as he has Rachel with him. While standing in the basement, he sees all these red roots on the wall, bright light shining through some holes, and he hears noises come from outside. The tripod comes down into the basement and is looking around for any humans. Harlan tries to hit it with an axe, but Ray somehow manages to stop him. As Harlan was moving around, he hits some stuff which ends up in a lot of noise. They outsmart the tripod and luckily it leaves. And then the alien probes come down to the basement looking for any humans. Harlan tries to shoot them, but Ray somehow manages to stop him. Harlan is screaming, which pisses off Ray, and then he sees the scene Harlan was looking at. Ray realizes that the end roots everywhere come from the blood of humans that tripods suck out of them. Human blood might be their fuel. Harlan goes digging a tunnel in the city. He goes crazy and hits Ray with a shovel when Ray tries to stop him. Ray needs to somehow quiet Harlan. First, he blindfolds his daughter with a black cloth and goes into the room. And Rachel tries to remain calm and is singing a lullaby. At night, Rachel comes face to face with the alien probe and Ray attacks the probe with the axe. Rachel goes upstairs and goes missing outside. Ray steps outside as well, looking for her, and sees the whole land is covered in red roots as he goes up the hill. The tripod appears on the scene chasing Ray while he hides in a car. The tripod tilts the car, and then the tripod picks up Rachel and leaves Ray behind, which makes Ray chase the tripod and shouts at him. Ray starts throwing grenades at the tripod that he finds in the military car and captivates his attention. And then the tripod picks up Ray and drops him with the other people in a cage. Ray finds Rachel among the people, and the tripod keeps them using their blood as fuel. A tentacle comes down to grab another human, and this time it's Ray. Ray takes the grenades up as he pulls up, but he's pulled down with the help of soldiers and other people. A soldier prepares everyone to be ready for an explosion as Ray splits out pins from grenades. The massive explosion takes place, and the tripod topples and the captives are liberated. Rachel and Ray reach Boston, and he notices the white ashy roots. Rachel asks what it is, and Ray explains to her that the tripods are dying. A tripod appears and soldiers are making sure all people hide in a tunnel. And then Ray sees birds around on the tripod and tells the soldiers that there is no shield on the tripod anymore. The soldiers start firing missiles and all bullets they have left on the tripod. The tripod falls down. The soldiers approach the tripod and see it dying frail limbs. The aliens died as well due to the microbes that inhabit the earth. Ray reaches Catherine's parents' home and Rachel sees her mother. Ray finds Robbie unharmed when they all meet each other. The end. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you would like to see more videos like this.